This is Africa. And this is the African art collection at the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. Every object in this gallery is a little piece of Africa. Hi, I'm Shelby. You and I are about to begin an adventure. We're going to explore Africa and African art. Africa and African art. Now, when I look at these objects, I can see Africa. How do I do that, you might ask? Well, I know five important facts about African art. Stick with me, and maybe you can see Africa in these objects, too. You know, in Africa, most objects are meant to be used. When we think of art in the United States, we usually imagine something that hangs on a wall or sits in a museum. But in Africa, art is part of the daily and spiritual life of the community. It's usually made for a very special reason. This looks like something we might call a costume. But actually, this is an Agungun mask. It represents an ancestor, a person who lived long ago. The ancestors live in the spirit world, but visit the living world during Agungun festivals. These festivals are held every year or when people need the help or advice of their ancestors who are very wise. If there's a family crisis or a community problem, the Agungun are called on to help. Masks like this are owned by one family. The family will ask a specially trained member of the community to dance this mask during an Agungun festival. Let's see what the mask wearer sees when he looks out. African art often describes someone from the spirit world. Eshu! Sounds like I sneezed, didn't it? But actually, Eshu is the name of a god in Africa. This is the staff of the god Eshu. Eshu carries messages from people to other gods. If you want Eshu to carry your message to these gods, you have to honor him. When you honor Eshu, he's glad to help you. But when you get him mad, he could play a trick on you. He may mix up your message or not deliver it at all. When you look real close, you can see that Eshu is playing a flute. It looks like a flute in the gallery. Eshu plays his flute to alert the gods that messages from humans are on their way. Check out Eshu's hair. It's shaped like a hook. Now look at this. If Eshu came into this room right now, that would be pretty strange, huh? Anyway, if he did, this is how he would look to us. Now look at this. This is the face he shows in the spirit world. African art is an important part of the community. African art is used to communicate with the gods, and people use it to communicate with each other. Take Arire here. His job is to keep peace in the community. Garire lives in the forest. He comes to the village to settle serious community arguments. He is so powerful, he can even stop wars. Garire listens to both sides of an argument and then decides what needs to be done. A man who has been specially trained to understand Garire stands nearby and tells the rest of the people what the spirit has decided. Look at the details of this mask. Each detail has a special meaning for the people of the community. The eyes have been painted with the white clay. The color tells us that Garire is beautiful and pure. Around the chin are leopard's teeth. They aren't real. They've been made out of a metal called brass. The teeth remind everyone that the forest where Garire lives can be a fierce place. The rest of the mask includes cloth, beads, and a kind of seashell called cowrie shells. This fancy clothing reminds us that unlike the forest, the world of people is elegant and civilized. Masks usually appear with dance, music, and song. Masks are probably the most popular and well-known type of African art. But did you know that when you see a mask like this, you're really only seeing a part of a mask? A whole mask includes the headpiece and a costume, like Garire over there. This mask is called Sowe. It fits over the head, so we call it a helmet mask. Raffia, a kind of plant, is attached through these holes on the bottom of the mask. The raffia hangs down and covers the mask wearer's body. Besides the mask and raffia skirt, the person wearing this mask is covered with a bodysuit. No part of the skin can be visible, not even a toe, or the spirit represented by the mask will not appear. So the person wears socks too. There's another part to the mask. That you can say you've seen the whole mask. Sowe, the mask we're looking at, is the only African mask known to be worn only by women. She takes girls away from the village to a special school. The girls practice skills like cooking, farming, and taking care of children. They also learn to use herbal medicines. Then Sowe returns them back to the village, ready for marriage. This mask shows an ideal woman. She's quiet and peaceful. Her eyes look down, and her mouth is small and quiet. She's also neat. Her hair is very fancy and shows that she cares about her appearance. The rings on the back of her neck may be rolls of fed. Now, I know we don't think of fed as good, but in this culture, hunger and sickness used to be common, so fed was special because it showed that you had enough to eat and were healthy. African art comes from many different cultures. This may be the most important fact of all. Not everyone in Africa looks the same, or speaks the same language, or believes the same things. Now, when a group of people share these things, they make up a culture, and there are hundreds of different cultures in Africa. The continent of Africa is gigantic. It would take about 325 days just to drive around the edge of Africa. That's almost a year. And because it's so big, the geography is very different. There are deserts, savannas, and rainforests. But did you know that there are no jungles in Africa? And it's not all wilderness. Africa has big cities, too. No wonder African art is so different. The art right here in the Virginia Museum has been made by many, many different cultures. Remember the big Ogunga mask? It was made by the Yoruba people. They also made the Eshu staff. The Yoruba have a big population. Today they live in the area around Nigeria and the Republic of Benin. Garire comes from the Dan culture. They live in Liberia and the Ivory Coast. And Sowe here was made by the Mende culture, living in Sierra Leone. Different cultures, different art. But now we've learned some things that the art of these cultures can share. Let's recap our African art facts. Most objects are meant to be used. African art often describes someone from the spirit world. African art is an important part of the community. Masks usually appear with dance, music, and song. African art comes from many different cultures. Now remember these five facts. They can help you see a little piece of Africa in all of these objects. See you later.